Got a mailbag. A cup of coffee. Mailbag. Literally a bag full of mail. Usually just open them as they get here because something I need in them. So first things first, let's move that out of the way. Let me get some of this stuff out of the way. And slide this on here. There we go. I should take these out of this bag. Sorry about that. Some stuff I picked up at a bargain place. HDMI to pretty nice racked HDMI DisplayPort. Thunderbolt, sorry. Sticker. I hate when they put stickers on stuff. Hopefully it works. Crimper. A cheap crimper. It's probably just a Chinese crimper. Seems to work. Probably could have gotten this on eBay. Same thing, but not waiting for shipping. It's not even a label. It's just a sticker. It's not even printed on the handle. Seems to be a generic manufacturer for Chinese fasten tools. Yeah, all right. It wasn't a great deal, but why not? Put a sticker on that one. That's my eyeglasses prescription. I don't know why it's in that bag. This is a repair tool. Oh, look at that. See, this is why you need to open your mail. Because I don't even remember ordering this, and this should have been in the fridge. Especially since it probably sat out in my mailbox at 90 degree weather. This is that knockoff Amtech. I think this is mechanic. This is supposed to be pretty decent mechanic. One second. Sorry, cats being crazy, knocking stuff over. Just had to make sure it was nothing. But cats, it's always cats. So, this is a mechanic solder paste, 6337, 2545 micron balls, 10 cc's. And I forgot I ordered this. Sweet. I actually plan on doing some SMD stuff, so I'll just put that over here with the rest of my solder. This is connectors, terminals. These are Let's get rid of these. These are pluggable terminal connectors. Well, terminal blocks. They're screw terminals, actually. Pluggable screw terminal blocks. These are three. I have two and fours, but I wanted some threes. Threes are for NeoPixels. If I'm going to run a string of NeoPixels, I want three pins for ground, 5 volt. And data, and for other sensors too. If I'm going to do like remote sensors for temperature or whatever, usually You need three wires for that. So that's added to my connectors bin. I don't know the quality of these. They feel like the same, all the Chinese knockoffs. There's no branding on them. Some of them feel shitty, crappier than the others. These feel pretty cheap. They're not nylon or anything. This is adapter. Is there anything in there? This is like cling bubble wrap. You guys ever seen cling bubble wrap? This is very cool. I wonder if I could buy rolls of this. No, this is not an adapter. Well, that's awfully a lot of packaging for LEDs. Apparently I only ordered two of them. I guess to test them out before I ordered more. I'm pretty sure these are NeoPixels, or I think the packaged ones are WS2811s, not 12s. I got a board. I'm testing a board out that I have a NeoPixel, a mount for NeoPixel surface mount, or you can put a through hole. And I think I'm also going to use these for an indicator and outside. I don't know how bright they are. They're probably not as bright as NeoPixels surface mount. WS2812 NeoPixels or SK6812s are not as bright either. But these are probably not as bright because they're frosted. But if they're bright enough for sunlight, I might put them outside as like a status indicator across the yard for something. I highly doubt that'll be possible. But maybe I could put a hood on it or something. I'm just gonna put this in a pile over here. Next module. That's pretty much almost all I buy is modules. This I'm surprised it's already got here. I don't even have my circuit boards yet that I got made that I bought this for. These are probably knockoffs. They're almost guaranteed to be a knockoff. This might be genuine. It's just got a generic hologram to make it look real. Oh, come on, guys. I'll have to be careful bending them back. Make sure you take a picture before you start bending stuff. Take a picture in case the lead snaps. You can send that picture and dispute the... Well, that's pretty heavy, but most of that might be the epoxy. This actually looks pretty nice. Most of the knockoffs I've seen don't have a cover on the bottom or a seal. They just have black fill epoxy, and this actually has a barcode, and the real ones I've seen have a barcode on them. So we'll have to see. Hopefully the footprint's correct. You know, this is a AC to DC converter module, 5 volt output, 5 watts. The most common ones of these are, I think, only 1 watt or 600 milliamps or something like that. And if you're going to run an ESP and some sensors, you're going to need more than that because it'll peak out at 800 milliamps when it's transmitting. So this should be good. I also plan on running a relay off of this too, so we'll see how it works. All right, cool. I did not expect to have that already. Settable fuses. This is also for a project I'm working on. I love when you get a little card, even though it's they usually go right in the trash, but it just shows that you're actually dealing with a real seller, not a stocked warehouse. Typical leave us positive feedback, blah, blah, blah. It's got this crazy artwork on it. The guy looks like a little monkey or something. Yeah, he's like a little monkey. This guy's on a horse. Journey to the West. It's known simply as Monkey. Classic novels of Chinese literature. Huh, that's cool. I might actually hold on to this. It's got a little story on it. Of course, they're relating it to their business of missions to deliver item to the buyer, blah, blah, hard, long trip. This is cute. I'll have to read that later. These are 6 volt, 1.5 amp polyfuses or poly switches. SMD, I think these are 0805s. These might be 12, these are 1206s. And I think these are, I got these 8 volt 2 amp, these are probably 1801s, I think. The bigger ones. I think they only come in that size when you're dealing with that kind of amperage. These look good. Gold. These look really good. They were really cheap. I'll see if I can find the eBay listing. Get in there. Get in there. I need to get some SMD bins or I'm going to lose all this stuff. Alright. I'm a sipper. I got to learn to not sip on camera. Or sniffle. These allergies have been bad for 2 months straight. 2 months straight of terrible allergies, extremely high pollen counts. Spring's been bizarre. We're just turning into June now, and it's not even 90 degrees yet, which is not normal. It's actually kind of cool. It's been raining and cool. This tropical storm's coming through the U.S. right now. If anybody's watching the... I don't know. I doubt people watch international weather, but it's pretty unique because the tropical storm came up through the Gulf and made its way all the way to Michigan. This is probably the first time that a tropical storm made its way all the way inland and hit the Great Lakes, which is bizarre. It didn't even fall apart. It's still spinning. You can actually watch the map, and it's just still a cyclone. Just spinning up into mainland. It's bizarre. In fact, we got a rain. We kept getting hit by the rain over and over again as the arms kept whipping back around because it came up through where I live. These are the bigger ones. I think these are 1812. Sorry, I was close. I said 1801. I think it's 1812. It's the SMD size. So... No, it's not even on here. 2010, 805, 1206, 1210, 2010. They must be different. I don't know what the footprint of. That's weird. I just have to get a better ruler. It doesn't have all the sizes on there. I've noticed this ruler is also missing a 18 gauge hole. I don't know why. Yeah, definitely get a new roll. This is just a cheap Chinese one. I need to get a nice one from somebody reputable. This says it's daily utensils. Daily utensils. That could be anything, especially electronics. Oh, it's a ESP01. ESP826601. I actually never got involved. I started playing with ESPs when the 12s came out. 12Es and the 12Fs. Basically Node MCU and the first Huzzah, Adafruit Huzzah, not the Feather, the one before that. And this is, I think I bought this for testing. I don't have an ESP01 with the 512K memory to test with, to make sure there's no code problems in some of my libraries. Also, they're nice and small. Sometimes you just need one I/O and you want to make something tiny. And if your sketch is small enough, I think you can still use OTA. So that's going to be the main goal, is I want to see if I can get... Because these are still cheap. These are like... I think you can get these now at a little over $2 if you buy them in some form of bulk. Maybe 10 units or something like that. This says plastic sheet. Whoa! Oh. All right, these are for those NeoPixels, or I might even figure out how to mount a normal NeoPixel in here, and just I might fill it with some kind of resin, clear resin. I basically need waterproof NeoPixels to use as a multifunction indicator. This is gonna go on my pool pump. I have a automating my pool pump. I'm using an old Intermatic timer, the old mechanical one. So I'm gonna replace it with some smarts in there. Probably an ESP project, and I have some beefy relays to turn my pump on and off. And I want to use these on the control unit that I can see across the yard, and I can use this to reflect the water temperature, status of the pump, and I can even do current sensing to make sure there's no problem. You could probably even detect pressure and problems and stuff like that, pump temperature, and just so you don't have to go out there and make sure everything's good. You know, depending on the pressure and the pump current draw, you can determine if the strainers needs to be pulled out. You probably determine a lot of stuff. If there's a lot of leaves, and check the load on the motor. So I thought I even thought about putting a UV sensor out there, and then having a light that just tells me what the UV index is near the pool, because if you're out there, you don't realize it's been 3 hours and it's overcast, and you don't realize you're going to be burnt. So I thought I could do all kinds of cool stuff with that. Or at a glance, see what the temperature is of the pool. And I'll probably use it for something else too. Diodes. These are not diodes, these are resistors. I don't have any SMD components, so I just bought a couple just to check them out and see what kind of qualities are out there for cheap. I'm probably going to buy a book. Good, they're labeled. They're all labeled. Sweet. Hopefully they're legible. No, they're crossed out. That's weird. Okay, most of them are labeled in English. That's awesome. I think these are 0805s. It's just a chart of the values, 1 ohm to 10 mega ohm, 1%, 740 pieces, 74 values. So 10 of each values. And I have some 0 ohm that I just bought separately to add to this kit. Because they never come with 0 ohm jumpers. These kits never come with 0 ohm. And I'll probably find out which values I need more of, 10K, 1K, 22, 222, some of the common ones that you use for pull-ups and pull-downs and LED limiting. I'm just going to put these all back in the bag for now because I have nowhere else to put them without losing them. This is hot melt glue. Oh my god, it's actually an accurate description because that is what I ordered. And that's not what I ordered. These are supposed to be black. Ugh, eBay, what you pay for. This is untracked. That's literally what it says, untracked. I'm kind of missing some stuff. I should have gotten some capacitors too. And I ordered a lot of different terminal connectors too. I only got half of what I ordered. It's probably be here this weekend, today or tomorrow. Three terminal blocks, screw terminal blocks. I only have two terminal blocks. And although you can put them together and make four, you can't get three. And again, NeoPixels, you want three temperature sensors. One wire devices, you want three terminals. So, I don't know what these are probably 5 mil spacing. It's pretty standard. I don't know what the current, these are probably good up to, well, they probably say 6 amps. I wouldn't run more than 3 amps through them. I don't know, they look pretty beefy and wide. Yeah, and the isolation's pretty good. These might be pretty good. I might actually test one to see how well they work. And that's it. That's all my mail. Not a lot of stuff. I thought I had a lot more in there. Seems like a lot. And especially when you get these little SMD components, it doesn't add up to much. I'm excited to try this out and test it out and see what the noise is on it. And see how hot it gets at full load. I'm excited. I've never reflow. I don't have a reflow oven or a toaster oven I can use. Can't use the one we cook in. Because this is leaded solder. And flux would probably not taste good in your toast. But yeah, I'm excited to use this. I have some SMD test boards and I just made a board that I should be getting today, I think. And I do have a hot air reflow. I have a Yihua 858D. Although for small boards, I should be able to hot air reflow it. I have a little candle warmer, so maybe I'll use that for preheat. I think if you preheat to 200 or something like that, you can reflow with a hot air gun really easily. And it should be able to closely match your curves that you want, so you're not heating half the board and half the other. So that should help. And then you also want the board to get hot enough so that your components align properly. So we'll see how that works. That's that for today. I'm trying to think if I have anything else to show that I opened early. Oh, I got some of these the other day. I opened them up because I thought I was going to be using them, but I didn't actually. I think these are USB hubs. Yeah, FE 1.1s. 4-port USB hub SOICs. SSOP28. And I got some breakout boards. I think I ordered 3 of them. Tiny little things. I've never soldered anything like that. I'm gonna have to get a new solder tip. I have a small one, but they didn't have the dimple one with the hoof with the dimple to hold the solder. I just have the one that's flat, so I don't think it's gonna work the same. It doesn't hold that well of solder in the tip. Solder. So we'll see how that goes. I also got new soldering work. I got this stuff, and it looks okay, but it's really crappy. I don't think it has enough flux on it or any, and it's not very flat. You can see how crappy it is by how bunched up it is. It's just all... It should be nice and flat woven. It's all kinked up. And it's even like that in here. It gets a little... So... it's just crappy. Gotta find some good solder wick. I got some new solder too. Got some stuff from Amazon. I bought this fine solder wire. This is 0.06 millimeter. I mean, 0.6 millimeter. 6040. I got these from Amazon too. They're Tamington. The labels are really cool. They're probably just the same old junk you get from any Chinese seller, but they, you know, they put a little effort into it. They came well packaged. I got lead free, 0.6 also. I tend to use a 0.6 a lot. I wish there was something in between 0.6 and 0.8, because this is just a little too thick. And this is 6337. Lead free. So I have lead free 6337 in two sizes. And I also have, I need to order some. I thought I did order some. Maybe I didn't get that yet. I'll go check my manifest. Where is my sign? I got some of this Kester 0.5 mil. And this is 6337. I thought I ordered some thicker lead-free. But I got 0.6 in 6040 and 6337 because sometimes when you're bridging a breadboard, you really need the extra flow time when you're trying to bridge stuff with solder. Sometimes it sets just way too fast, which is what you want. You want this solder to set fast, but sometimes when you're just freestyling a solder in a breadboard, you kind of need some leeway. And I've not used this enough to judge it, whether it's good or not, but I mean, the reviews were okay on Amazon, and the shipping was cheap, so I thought, hey, I can get solder tomorrow and not in 8 weeks, so it's probably the same thing, though. I could have got it for half price if I just bought it from China. So that's that. See you later.